Welcome to next session of Microwave Engineering. In today's session, we are going to take bunching process of Klystron. In last lecture, we have already covered velocity modulation. I hope the concepts are clear for you. Now we're going to start with bunching process. To start with the bunching process, I hope you understand. This is accordingly a positive half cycle, a negative half cycle, and a zero cross section. During positive half cycle, the electrons are accelerated, they move at a faster pace. During the negative half cycle, the velocity is retarded, they move at a slower pace. Zero cross section, the velocity remains unchanged. The same thing is been shown over here. We are trying to find the bunching process, means we need to find out where do we keep the output cavity or catcher cavity. We need to find the value of this L. That is the drift space at which you are going to keep the catcher cavity. In the catcher cavity, current modulation is going to take place. So how do we start it? Is that why it is written same over here? Because it is zero cross section, velocity will remain the same, meaning the velocity is going to be small v naught. What was small v naught? DC electron velocity. What happens at the faster phase? We are talking about this faster phase. At faster phase, the velocity is going to be v max. What is v max? Means according to the velocity modulated equation, the sine function has to be positive over there. For slower, it's going to be V minimum. In V minimum, the sine function is going to be negative over here. The distance between all these equations has to be pi by 2 omega, pi by 2 omega. Please note that the zero cross section, the time period is taken TB, slower is TA, TC, and the final destination is taken as TD. So if somebody comes and asks you to find the distance L, L will be always velocity multiplied by time. Distance is equal to speed into time. As a result, your speed can be written as L, that is L is equal to V naught, because same as DC electron velocity, multiplied by this TD minus TB. This TD, you can see over here, TD minus TB. I'm talking about the V naught, where the velocity is not changed. Suppose the velocity is changed. Suppose the velocity change, meaning I'm talking about the slower one, what will you do? For the slower one, you will say L. L is equal to, again, this is V minimum, because lesser velocity, V minimum, into TD minus TA. How much is TA in comparison to TB? It is TB minus pi by 2 omega. TC will be TB plus pi by 2 omega. I hope you understand. Now see how we apply the equations. As shown in the diagram, we had already explained that your delta L, in that diagram it was shown delta L. So V naught TD minus TN, this is for the same one. Whenever your electrons are accelerated, you are going to get maximum velocity. So that maximum velocity, we have written it over here as V max into TD minus TC. As in the diagram, we have already explained that. And for the minimum, we are getting V minimum TD minus TA. TA in terms of TB is written as TB minus of pi by 2 omega. When you open the bracket, it becomes plus. This is TB plus pi by 2 omega. When you open the bracket, is going to be minus. What is V minimum? According to velocity modulated equation, we have already seen in the first lecture that velocity modulated equation had a sine quantity over here. Do you recollect that? Had a sine quantity over here. So this sine quantity can be negative or positive. We have arranged that sine quantity to be negative so that it becomes V minimum. So what happens for the positive one? To find the distance L, we are going to equate the equations, because we know that both the sides it is going to be same. V minimum into TD minus this and V max into TD minus this is going to be equivalent. So we are just equivalent, we are equalizing both the equations, and we'll write this equation in such a form that all the voltages come in one side and time comes in another side. Can you all see this? All the voltages have come to one side and TD, this has come to one side. Then we are going to apply component and dividend of functions. So according to that function, it is numerator plus denominator upon numerator minus denominator. When you are solving that equation, you finally come to. So on solving the component and dividend equations, we have solved it for you. You can also try it for yourself. You will come to an equation in which on the left hand side it is TD minus TB, and on right hand side you are going to get the equation in terms of V naught pi upon omega beta I into V1. Now actually L is supposed to be V naught. We have just marked it over here, this V naught. This V naught multiplied by this equation. Now the question that comes is, who decides the bunching distance? Meaning at what space will you keep the catcher cavity? So that current modulation takes place. Now who decides according to you? Can we just go through it, the equation? This is pi. Pi, can pi go on varying? Answer is no. Particular frequency is fixed, so that frequency remains as it is. So 2 pi f cannot change. Beta, if you remember, we take ideally as 1. It is input beam coupling coefficient. Ideally, we take it as 1. Then comes the question of V0. V0 is, then comes the question of this V1 first. Let us take the denominator. This V1, what do you think about this V1? V1 is the input voltage. It's an amplifier. We decided 10 volts. We are expecting 20 volts at the output. We cannot go on changing the input. If we go on changing the input, then the output also varies. So the V1 will remain fixed. Pi is a constant. Pi is a constant. What is V0? Small V0. Small V0 is DC electron velocity, that is 0.593 into 10 to power 6 into square root of V0. So in that equation, it is depending on capital V0. And here also we have V0. In other words, who decides the bunching distance? If somebody asks you, the bunching distance is always decided by the DC accelerating voltage. Please notice, it is always decided by the DC accelerating voltage. In other words, we say, Klystron is always provided with a variable DC supply. Why Klystron is provided with a variable DC supply? Variable DC supply so that the distance of bunching gets, you can adjust the distance at which bunching takes place. I hope you understood today's lecture. Thank you very much.